Hello everyone and welcome to Learnaholic India. In today's session, we are going to see software project management activities. The topics that we are going to cover in today's session are list of software management activities, need for configuration management, and the people who are involved in the configuration management. So without wasting the time, let's start. Software project management consists of many activities that includes planning of the project, deciding the scope of the project, estimation of cost in different terms, scheduling of the task, etc. Now, we will discuss all these activities in detail. So first is project planning. It is a set of multiple processes, or we can say that it is a task that performed before the construction of the product start. The next one is scope management. Scope management describes the scope of the project. Scope management is important because it clearly defines what would do and what would not. Scope management creates the project to contain restricted and quantitative tasks, which may merely be documented and successively avoids price and time overrun. The third activity is estimation management. This is not only about the cost estimation, because whenever we start to develop the software, but we also configure or we figure out their size, that is nothing but line of code, efforts, time, as well as cost. If we talk about the size, then the line of code depends upon the user or software requirement. If we talk about the efforts, we should know about the size of the software, because based on the size, we can quickly estimate how big team required to produce the software. If we talk about the time, when the size and efforts are estimated, the time required to develop the software can easily determine. And we talk about the cost, then it includes all the elements such as size of the software, quality of the software, hardware used in the software, the communication, training, additional software and tools, and the skill manpower. The fourth activity is scheduling management. Scheduling management in the software refers to all the activities to complete in the specified order and within the time slot to each activity. Project managers define the multiple tasks and arrange them keeping various factors in the mind. For scheduling, it is compulsory to find out the multiple tasks and correlate them. Then divide the time into the units. After that, assign the respective number of work per units for every job. Then calculate the total time from start to finish. And after that, break down the project into the modules. After that, project resource management comes into the picture. In software development, all the elements are referred to as resources for the project. It can be a human resource, productive tools, and libraries. Resource management includes create a project team and assign the responsibility to every team member. Next is developing a resource plan, which is derived from the project plan. Then adjustment of the resources. After the project resource management, project risk management comes into the picture. Risk management consists of all the activities like identification, analyzing, and preparing the plan for predictable and unpredictable risk in the project. Several points to show the risk in the projects are: the experienced team leaves the project and the new team joins in. Then changes in the requirement, change in the technologies and the environment, and market competition. The seventh activity is project communication management. Communication is an essential factor in the success of the project. It is the bridge between the client, organization, team members, and as well as other stakeholders of the project, such as hardware suppliers. From the planning to closure, communication plays a vital role. In all the phases, communication must be clear and understood. Miscommunication can create a big blunder in the project. The last activity is project configuration management. Configuration management is about to control the changes in the software like requirement, design, and development of the product. The primary goal is to increase the productivity with fewer errors. Then we will see some reasons to show the need for the configuration management. Several people work on the software that is continuously updating, help to build a coordination among the suppliers. Changes in the requirement, budget, schedule need to accommodate. And the last need for configuration management is that the software should run on the multiple systems. The next topic is tasks performed in configuration management. These are identification, baseline, change control, configuration status accounting, and configuration audits and reviews. Now, which are the people who are involved in the configuration management? The people are nothing but the project manager, configuration manager, developers, and the users. Thank you for watching today's session. If you are new to this channel, then subscribe to Learnaholic India. And don't forget to click on the bell icon for the latest video updates. If you like today's video, then like it, share it with your friends. Also, if you have any query, then please comment below. Remember one thing, sharing of knowledge is gaining of knowledge. That's it for today. Stay tuned for next video. Thank you.